morning. Welcome back to Concept Learning Channel. In the last class, we were talking about coordination as an essence of the function of management. Now, in this class, we need to understand what are the features of the coordination. Now, when we talk about features of coordination, once it is done, we will understand it through the example also. Okay, when we say features of coordination, the first feature it says that there has to be an integration of the group efforts. Coordination brings group efforts together. It integrates all the employees, all the heads, all the departments, and they have to work together. How? Let us see through example. If you talk about human resource plus production department of any company, they have, let's say HR, human resource, they have to coordinate with sales department, with finance department, with purchase department. Why? Because we to see recruitment process, staffing process, that will be done by HR only, and they have to understand the needs of the different departments. To understand the needs of the different departments, they need to have a cordial coordination between the different departments. So it says that there is integration of group efforts. It integrates group efforts, first feature of coordination. Then it ensures unity of efforts. Every organization has its own goals that we have studied. So unity of efforts, if we are not able to ensure unity of efforts, if coordination is not there between the different departments, how the organization is going to achieve the goal of the organization? That is not possible. That means everyone has to work together in a teamwork to achieve the common goals of the organization. That is the ultimate aim of the organization, to achieve profit maximization and goals of the organizations. So, if you see coordination, it ensures unity of efforts. All are working together in a team to achieve the common goals. Then it says that it is continuous process. It is continuous in nature. That is true because coordination doesn't end with one department. For example, let us say production department. They are producing low quality products. Now this low quality goes into the stores, then goes to the customers. They are not satisfied. What happens? Sales revenue doesn't go high. What if effect it will give to the finance department? There will be losses. So what is happening? Because production department did not coordinate with the other departments, did not coordinate with their own workers, how they are working, what are their grievances, are they listening to them or no, finance, are we really running short of finance, or we can utilize, underutilize and overutilization of resources, that all coordination was not there. Because it was not there, finance department or the organization had to suffer losses. So if you see, it is a continuous process. Then comes, it is pervasive. Now pervasive means, we know, it is universal. Means it is applicable everywhere. Coordination is applicable in all the aspects of the organization. It is interrelated with other departments, with staff, employees and the management of the company. So it is pervasive. Then responsibility of all heads. When all the departments are involved, it becomes the responsibility of all the heads of the organization to come together and coordinate with each other so that they are able to achieve the common goals of the organization. And the last but important, it is a deliberate function. What is deliberate? Means it is a compulsory function that has to take place between all the departments of the organization because they have to achieve the common goals of the organization. So deliberate efforts are being put by all the departments and the employees to achieve the common goals of the organization. Example, let's see, HR and production department of the company, they have to coordinate with sales, they have to coordinate with purchase, and they have to coordinate with finance, etc. Because coordination will only lead them to the success of the organization. I hope this concept is clear to you. We will meet in the next class. Till that time, stay tuned in on YouTube channel Concept Learning. Like, comment, share, and come back to the class. Thank you.